Welcome to the course. Before moving on, there are several things that I need to mention and to make clear first. First, about the structure of the course. I have carefully crafted the curriculum so that everything is placed sequentially. Each lessons you take in one level will become the foundation of the lessons on the next levels. Therefore, it is important that you take the course in order, step by step, not jumping around. If you take the course by jumping around lessons, most likely you will get confused in some point, because I usually will not repeat lessons which already explained in the previous videos. The second thing I need to mention is that you need to practice. For each video, please try out the lessons yourself at least once. The course is not just about theories. Most of the lessons are practical skills. So again, you need to practice a lot if you really want this online course to benefit you. Several conventions for this course. I'll be using PC computer, so every shortcut I mention in the video will be for PC users. For Mac users, mostly you simply need to change the control keyboard shortcut to command keyboard shortcut, okay? Next is the document template. Adobe Illustrator has a lot of presets for documents. You can use RGB or CMYK, you can use pixels or centimeters, or even points for measurements, not to mention sizes. Basically, to make things less confused down the road, and so that we have the same setting to start with, in this course I'll be using Android 1080p preset, but set the orientation to landscape. For those of you who couldn't find this preset, just use these values each time you open a new file. Set the document's width to 1920 pixels. Set the height to 1080 pixels. Set the color mode to RGB and the measurement units to pixels. And lastly, for raster effects, set it to screen or 72 ppi. If in the future video lessons I set up certain values such as blur values or brush width values, but the appearance that you have in your file is a bit different from mine, it's a big chance that you set up the documents differently. So please check your document values first if this ever happened to you. Throughout the course, I'll be displaying a lot of images. Some of these images are not made by me. I am using them merely as source of inspiration and as reference for all of us to study, because I think they are great artworks. Okay? If I can find the owner's name of the image, I will try to add credits for him or her on top of the image. Otherwise, I will display the image as is. If I don't specifically state that the image is made by me or has my watermark on it, it means those images belong to its respectful owners or artists. I do not claim those images are made by me, okay? Let's move on to our first video lesson.